Side Journey set. My name is Soweto, and this fantastic sort of musicians you're about to hear, we're going to be playing a special tribute to Mr. Thelonious Monk. So we're going to start with a title that he self-titled, dedicated to himself. This is called Thelonious. She's an incredible vocalist, as I just said, and she's doing a rendering of the kind of life of Thelonious Monk in her own way. Please make some noise for TrueMendous!
Evangelists playing the church organ. The band's a key, the reason why their churches wasn't boring. I mean, I shut it down on that whistling stool. I could make an old lady backflip into baptism pools. I was that guy with the fingers, make congregations spaz. And then a few years down the line, I started playing jazz. Mr. 1940s house pianist, trailing patterns so bizarre, we made the crowd gasp in fits. And then it's Playhouse, a cool Manhattan nightclub. Beautiful women who tried to black before the night's done. I developed my style there, by women with star hair, heart swimming, so the women would dig and recite, yeah. Crucially, formulation of bebop, later further by other musicians, including these love. Dizzy Gillespie, Charlie Christian, and Kenny Clark. Charlie Parker's and Miles Davis, but what takes me up was leeches writing on shirt cuffs and tablecloths, scribbling down my ideas like I was drunk. The beret and bar glasses was mine. Ask Mary Lou, and I'm a baby wondering, Mary Lou. And I'm a baby wondering, Mary Lou. And now you wondering, okay. In 1944, I made my first studio recordings with the Coleman Hawkins. In 1947, I made my first as a leader for Blue Note, which showcased my talent for a panel for Blue Notes. Composer of original melodies for improvisation, enhanced the greatness with Hennessy. Start playing now and then to bust a two-step for critics in that same year. Also married my missus. 47 to 52, developed new ears. Under contract, Prestige Records for 2 years. Got several highly significant albums with highly unrecognized outcomes for 2 years. Studio rooms with a Fat Roach. Collaborations with Sonny Rollins, Art Blakely and Max Roach. Roll with a Fat Roach until I snapped and the buzz was done. But August 1951, came and messed it up. After a show, face swabbing a towel. Police found narcotics in the car with myself a pal. Pissed cause I wouldn't tell, so confiscated my voice. My New York City cabaret card declined and made void. Like, oh boy, the Mexicans came with them stickers. Meaning I couldn't play in New York venues that serve liquor. Wow, this severely restricted my ability to perform for several years. Would they even remember me? Pigs. So instead I spent most of my early to mid-1950s composing and performing at out-of-town gigs and theatres. In 54 I balanced Christian P. Participated in a session while on Christmas Eve, which produced most of the album That's Groove, baby. And Miles Davis running jazz giants in my playlist. In 54 I went to Paris, recorded solo piano sessions for French radios that I could jam with. Was later issued as an album by Disco, working overseas to the camera lens with Dispose. Sight, I mean, I felt like a passion is. My mentor Mary Lou introduced me to Baroness, Panonica, Koenigswater, and a patroness. Of several new musicians, bizarre and passionate, and stayed a close friend throughout, just wanted better for me. even took responsibility when we were charged with marijuana possession. But psh, yo, that's another story. No, that's another story. No, that's another story. No, that's another. 55, 61, I was still going. Highly regarded by my peers and critiques, but due respect from outsiders to them folks, I was still owing. Too complex and difficult for them be. I made my own class, teaching the teacher, my teacher's own job. What unappreciated, about to get so wild. But God, it's time and it's here, increase my profile. My God, it's time and it's here, increase my profile. Creating two jazz albums was in my resume. In 55, Thelonious do plays do play in 10. In 56, unique Thelonious Monk. I worked my butt off and I there got recognised from the job. But brilliant corners was so difficult. Man, I needed breaks. The several versions needed several takes. But the album, however, was received by several as great. Just tick, I needed to make several for my resume. In 62, I signed the Columbia Records through statements. Now Riverside, they owe me royalty payments. But it's Oteo Masiro. I need more spice for me. Our first album out in 1963. And this promoted way more heavily. Monk Street, best-selling LP of my lifetime. And I waited a lifetime, like back-to-back centuries. You see, this gift here was sent for me. So anything that came from it was meant for me, huh? My name's Thelonious Monk. My name's Thelonious Monk. My name's Thelonious Monk. So what I did was I just invaded Wikipedia, I wrote a transcript in a soliloquy, acting as Thelonious Monk and just spoke about different periods in his lifetime, good and bad. And it was interesting because, and I actually enjoyed it more so because it was the fact that he didn't really achieve a recognition that early in his lifetime for being so complex and so diverse at a period where no one else was. So for the fact that he kept striving and carried on continuing to push his music and staying cool and true to himself, that's what I related to the most. And so shout out to Thelonious Monk for happy birthday.
But it's been great pulling together a show, quite, you know, late notice, but pulling it together with some really creative people. With the brief, obviously, that we're celebrating Thelonious Monk's life, so it's been really exciting to pull that apart. Working with TrueMendous, who's really creative with the words and ideas, and, you know, give us something that will stimulate a backdrop. It was a very easy process creating. So, and of course, given Thelonious Monk's interesting life, we couldn't help but pour some energy into remembering that.
Tonight it was really special, like getting to play some obscure Thelonious Monk tunes, some repertoire that I, to be honest, hadn't played before. But I absolutely love the work of Thelonious. And yeah, it was just really cool to play with Soweto and the guys, and TrueMendous as well. It was really cool. We like worked out this new tune that TrueMendous had written the lyrics for. So we workshopped it in the day, and it's been amazing fun.
Yeah, it was really good fun. Nice venue, nice sound. It's really nice to mix things up with TrueMendous as well as Soweto. Play that hip hop at the end. It was really good. Nice new experience for everybody.
That's been really well. We had a rehearsal today, which is the first time we met TrueMendous. And we came up with what we're going to do with that tune and how we can make that be inspired by Monk. But no, it was really fun and really good play.
It's been an exciting journey putting this together in Birmingham. Partnering growing up with ACM and their young students, getting to see these professional jazz musicians do their thing, and Rowana, the amazing bar manager of RJJZ Jazz Club Cafe. Make sure you check it out. And it's been such a fantastic journey commemorating the 100th birthday of the iconic jazz musician, Thelonious Monk. And it's been a pleasure. It's been amazing. Thank you.
It was enjoyable, and I hope we have Soweto back. And in terms of learning a little bit more about the artist himself, which is Thelonious Monk, I thought it was quite insightful.
Instead I spent most of my early to mid 1950s composing and performing at out of town gigs and theatres. In 1954 I balanced Christian Peak.